Welcome back to EdTech School. Today's video is about creative uses of timelines. Your natural reaction is probably, oh, that's just for history lessons. But I'll show you it can be useful in almost all other classes as well. And I'll share my top picks for making your own timelines. If you like me to make more videos just like this one, give it a thumbs up. A timeline represents events over a period of time. The events can be over a long period of time, or just a day, or even less. Let's get the most obvious use out of the way: history lessons. Timelines are extremely useful to show important events over a period of time. This example is an interactive timeline of the life of Nelson Mandela created by Time magazine. You can easily make these timelines yourself in any art graphic program like PowerPoint, Keynote, Illustrator, you name it. Microsoft has some nice looking templates available for Word, Excel and PowerPoint, which can be used as a good starting point. But I always find these timelines static without any interactivity. We can do better than that. Adding interactivity is what makes a great timeline stand out. There are nice online resources available to make your own timeline. Timeline.js is a project of the Northwestern University Knight Lab. They develop prototypes that help make information meaningful. The Nelson Mandela one I showed earlier is created with this website. Most online timeline builders are lacking some features that would make them a good fit for in the classroom. The one I miss most is reporting and the ability for students to change or rearrange a timeline. That's why I'm a big fan of the BookWidgets timeline widget. When creating a timeline, you can choose between two modes. Use the fixed timeline mode to create a static timeline just for viewing. But I think you should really try out the editable mode. This allows students to add events to the timeline and change the order. I believe that editable timelines are very useful in the classroom. The teacher can start with adding a couple of events and students can complete the timeline. The results are available in the BookWidgets dashboard. In this example, you can see that two events are already added by the teacher and the student gets the task to complete the timeline. They can even add pictures to events. Another approach is having a timeline with events in the wrong order. Now your students have the task to rearrange them in the right order. So, that's history, but what about other courses? In science classes, you can use a timeline as a note-taking and reporting tool. Each step in the project will be a new event on the timeline, where students can add a status, picture, or subcomments. Some teachers showed me they use an editable timeline to create a simple week planner. Create an event for every day in a week and put the tasks in there. Explaining the different steps in a process, for instance, writing a story or a poem, can also be done with a timeline. Simply create an event for every step of the process and place the text or images explaining the steps into each one. And of course, processes are everywhere, so this really applies to all courses. For comprehensive reading exercises, an editable timeline can help students to write down the story structure. Have you found other creative uses of timelines? Be sure to let me know in the comments below. If you want to make your own timelines, I left the links of these tools in the video description. Good luck!